Hello everyone, this is me Garima Singh. I hope you are doing well. Today I'll discuss the 9th chapter, that is international trade. We are discussing geography of class 12, so let's quickly move on to our topic, international trade. Firstly, we will discuss history of international trade. Earlier, barter system was used in ancient time where goods are exchanged in place of goods. Then later on, money came as a medium of exchange, and that was very helpful. Then there comes coins, it's copper, then silver, then now it's rupees. So there is basically stages. Now we are using currency, so we have a particular medium of exchange so that we can evaluate the value of every material. In history, it's mentioned that ancient time trade was restricted to local markets. Slowly long distance trade developed, of which Silk Route is an example. That the route was 6,000 kilometers long, that was connecting Rome to China, and traders basically Chinese silk, Rome wool, metals are transported. Then there is a slave trade emerged in 15th century, in which the Portuguese, Dutch and Spanish, British captured African natives and sold to plantation owners in America. Then international trade is the result of specialization in production and division of labor. Now we will discuss basis of international trade. So it's basically international trade is depend on difference in national resource. Basically, resources are unevenly distributed in the world. Then geological structure, this means relief feature, type of land such as fertile, mountain, lowland that support agriculture, tourism. Then mineral resource, the region rich in mineral will support industrial development that lead to trade. Then climate, it influences the type of flora and fauna that is found in regions such as wool production in cold region. Population factor, the size, distribution and diversity of population between countries affect the trade in respect of type and volume of goods. Then there is a culture factor. Difference in national, I have discussed geographical, mineral, climate, population factor. Population is basically some place sparsely populated, some they are densely populated, that also play important role. Then a cultural factor, distinctive form of art and craft developed in certain culture and give rise to trade. Stage of economic development, industrialized nation, export machinery, finished goods. Then aspect of international trade, we have volume of trade, composition of trade. Then volume of trade, it is measured simply as the total value of goods and services traded. Then composition of trade, earlier primary goods were more in total traded goods. Then there was dominance of manufactured goods, now there is a dominance of service goods. Then direction of trade, earlier valuable goods and artifacts were exported to European countries by developing countries. Later in 19th century, manufactured goods from European country were exchanged with foodstuff and with raw material from their colonies. Now discuss our type of international trade, bilateral, where two countries are involved, multilateral, number of countries. So bilateral, it is between two countries and they enter into an agreement to trade certain goods in which they are specialized. Multilateral trade, it is conducted with many trading countries at the same time at goods which the country has specialized. The country may also grant the status of MNF, that is most favored nation, on some of trading partner. Then cases of free trade, balanced trade also. Balanced trade, cases of free trade or trade liberalization is the act of opening up of economy so that more trade take place. This is done by bringing down trade barriers like tariff, but trade liberalization causes competition and can cause Dumping also. Dumping is the selling of commodity in two countries at a price that differ for reason not related to cause. Then balance of trade. It refers to volume of goods and services imported and exported by one country to other country. Favorable balance of trade means the value of export is more than import. Then let's discuss World Trade Organization. Let's discuss about this. Earlier it was GATT, then later on transforming it became WTO. The GATT General Agreement for Tariff and Trade was formed in 1948 to make world free from tariff as well as non-tariff barrier. Then it became GATT on 1st January 1995. The GATT was transformed into the World Trade Organization. That was 1st January 1995. Set up an institution for the promotion of free and fair trade amongst different countries of the world. WTO set the rule for the global trading system. However, WTO has been criticized and opposed by those who are worried about the effect of free trade in economic globalization. They also argue that issue of health, worker rights, child labor, and movement are ignored. Then regional trade bloc. These are developed as a response to the failure of global organization. There are 120 regional trade bloc that generate 52% of the world trade. Regional trade bloc like India's, it's SARC, there is North Siberia, NAFTA. Then ASEAN, that is basically regional here. ASEAN, Association of Southeast Asian Nations. Its headquarters in Indonesia, Jakarta. Then its member are these countries. Their origin, then Commonwealth of Independent State. Its headquarters remains Belarus. These are its countries. Then European Union. These are its countries. Then Latin American Integration Association. Its headquarters. Then NAFTA, OPEC, SAFTA. There's a number of here. Only few important are given. There are a number of regional trade bloc. Concern related to international trade. So merit of you can write merit and demerit. Merit of international trade, you can write international trade is beneficial if it promotes regional specialization, higher level of production, better standard of living, worldwide availability of goods and equalization of price and wages. Then it's demerit of international trade is that it lead to dependence on other countries, uneven level of development, exploitation and commercial rivalry. Then gateway of international trade. Harbor and ports are the chief gateway of international trade. These ports facilitate the passage of cargoes and traveler as well as provide facility of docking, loading, unloading. Type of ports. Ports are generally classified according to the type of traffic which handle. Type of ports like industrial ports, commercial port, comprehensive port. So let's discuss industrial port. The port that handle bulk cargo like grain or oil, chemical are called. They basically handle bulk cargo. Then commercial port handling packaged product, manufactured goods. Passenger are commercial ports. Packaged product, manufactured goods and passenger commercial. Then comprehensive ports. Ports that handle bulk and general cargo in large volume. Most of the world great ports are classified as comprehensive port. Then we will discuss a type of port on the basis of location. Inland port and outport. Outports. Inland port located away from the sea coast and linked to the sea through a river or a canal are inland port. Example, Mannheim on Rhine River. Outport port in deep water built away from the actual port and serving big ships are called outports. Athens and its outport Piraeus in Greece. Inland port located away from the sea coast. They are away from sea coast and linked to the sea through a river. Then outport deep water built away from actual port. Type of port, there were location inland out. Then specialized function. Oil port port that deal in processing and shipping of oil. Then port of call, port which originally developed as calling point on the main sea route or ships used to anchor or for refueling, watering and taking food item or called port of call, Honolulu in Aden, then packet station, also known as ferry port. These are exclusively concerned with transportation of passenger and mail across water bodies, basically cover short distance, Dover in England, Calais in France, then intra ports. These are collection centers which there the goods are brought from different countries. Then naval ports, these port serve workships and have repair workshop for them, Kochi, Karwar in India. So these are different bases based on location. It's inland, outport, then specialized oil port, port of call, the originally developed calling point, then ferry station, pocket station, ferry ports, intra ports. We are discussed with the crux. Let's discuss question and answer. Question and answer way easy if you get the crux of this chapter. Let's start. Most of the world great ports are classified as comprehensive ports. Then which one of the following continent has the maximum flow of global trade? That is North America. Which one of the following South American nation is part of OPEC? Venezuela. Then Venezuela. In which of the following trade bloc is Indian associate member? It's SAFTA. You have to answer, these are very short type of question. First is, what is the basic function of World Trade Organization? So World Trade Organization is to act as an international organization to deal with the global rule of trade between nations. It sets the rule for the global trading and resolve dispute between member nation. It is permanent institution for looking after the promotion of free and fair trade among nation. Basically, WTO also cover trade in services such as telecommunication and banking and other issues such as intellectual rights. Then why is it detrimental for a nation to have negative balance of payment? Negative balance of payment indicate that for a country, the expenditure on import is higher than income from export. This implies that country is running down on its stock of foreign exchange and it has to bank upon international loan for funding the payment of import. Then next is, what benefit do nation get by forming trade blocs? Countries with geographical proximity, similarity and complementaries in trading item from trading bloc. This develops as a resource to failure of global organization to speed up inter-regional trade. Intra, the main benefit that is increase intra-regional trade by removing trade tariff. Then have a greater say in international market as they have more power as a trading bloc than as an individual nation. So answer the following, these are a little bit longer. How are port helpful for trade? Give a classification of port. So commercial port of a harbor containing facility of embarking, disembarking, passenger loading and unloading, facility of storage are called ports. Ports are called gateways of international trade, cause 95% of international trade is carried out through port. Then cargoes and traveler passes from one of the world to another through these port. On the basis of ports, they are classified into two parts, that is inland port and outports. Inland are located away from the sea coast and they are located, these are deep water port built away from actual port. And these port are located away from sea coast. They are linked to the sea through a river or canal. So that was about even worldwide availability of goods and services before. Okay, we are done with this one. Okay, next, how do nations gain from international trade? International trade is a result of specialization in production. It benefits the world economy if different countries practice a specialization and division of labor in the production of commodity or provision of service. Each kind of specialization can give rise to trade. Thus, international trade is based on the principle of comparative advantage, complementary and transferability of goods and services, and in principle should be mutually beneficial to the trading partner. High level of production, then better standard of living, worldwide availability of goods and services before liberalization of international trade. All goods were not available in all part of world, which deprived both consumer as well as producer of developing countries. With international trade, both consumer and producer benefit from the availability of goods. So we are done with this chapter. We have studied basically international trade, various regional block and ports, discuss the importance of international trade, then regional trade block, WTO. That's all in this chapter is all about. That's for today. In next lecture we will discuss 10th chapter. Go through this video. Thank you.